Hallo zusammen, I'm your vlog Dave. If you're interested in German vocabulary and learning German words for things around the house and inside the house, inside different rooms, typical objects that you can find in every flat, every apartment, and what they are called in German, well, this is your way to go. And just two more things real quick. This is German vocabulary overload. Really, believe me. It's a lot of vocabulary, but it might as well be very helpful to you. And last but not least, definitely in this case, some of these videos were filmed in 2015, back when I just started out making videos on YouTube, and you will definitely notice that. You can even hear that from me speaking English back in the day and compared to how I speak English nowadays and how it's improved. So if you don't mind that, well, feel free to listen along, to watch along, and to have a great time with these videos, which hopefully might be helpful to you. And hey, maybe this can even be motivational to you, because it shows that everyone can improve their spoken language skills over time by just speaking and, you know, using the language. I hope you're gonna enjoy these little room tours, which, by the way, was my old flat. I'm not living there anymore, so you know, maybe there's gonna be an updated one in the future at some point. Anyway, enjoy watching. I'm your vlog Dave, and see you next time. The room I'm about to enter could be named the dining room, das Esszimmer. But in our case, it's basically part of the living room, so I will take this into this video as well. Let's see what we can find here. Der Schrank. Die Kaffeemühle. Das Porzellan. Oder das Service. Plural die Service. Die Vase. Na. Das Aquarium. And swimming inside are die Fische. Plural. Singular der Fisch. And they even have a sushi bar. Lucky bastards. Die Gardine. Singular, Plural, die Gardinen. Die Lampe. Oder der Deckenfluter. Das Bild. Plural, die Bilder. It's so beautiful outside. But very hot actually. 30 degrees Celsius. Don't know how that equals to Fahrenheit. Maybe someone can tell me that in the comments down below. Die Pflanze. Der Kratzbaum. Die Uhr. And in this case, it's die Wanduhr, because it's hanging on the wall. Das Pendel. Der Tisch. Die Tischdecke. Der Stuhl. Plural, die Stühle. Der Laptop. We do have a German word for this thing, der Klapprechner, but actually No one uses that. Das Sideboard. Die Serviette. Plural, die Servietten. Some little forks here, and maybe you can remember that German expression? Der Teller. Plural, die Teller. Die Schüssel. Plural, die Schüsseln. Der Teppich. Plural, die Teppiche. In the right bottom corner you see a brown blanket, and a blanket is die Decke. Plural, die Decken. It's basically the same word for ceiling, above us.
Brusi. Hello.
This is Brusi. You might have seen him in the cats vlog. The cats video that I did. He is a ragdoll cat, and he is very charming.
He's so cute.
By the way, it's die Katze. Plural, die Katzen. And in his case, because he's a male cat, it's der Kater. Das Kissen. Plural, die Kissen. Der Beistelltisch. Die Fernbedienung. Plural, die Fernbedienung. Das Regal. Plural, die Regale. With lots of CDs in it. Such a great game, by the way. Der Fernseher. Der Lautsprecher. And der Lautsprecher is a part of die Anlage or die Soundanlage. Or die Musikanlage. You have many different options for this one. Der Schrank, once again. Or in this case, der Wohnzimmerschrank. With lots of books in it. By Stephen King, mainly. And all the stuff you're seeing here is die Dekoration. das CD-Regal. Der Sessel. Das Sofa. Or die Couch. Der Hocker. Die Näpfe. Singular der Napf. And some cat toy, yay. And guess who's coming? Of course, it's Brucey. He's very curious.
Brucey.
Der Spiegel.
And who is this guy? I don't know.
Once again, die Lampe. Die Decke. And the opposite, der Boden, or der Fußboden. This is pretty much an updated and remastered version of my German room tour videos from way back in the day. Back then when I filmed stuff with my smartphone and I didn't have the fancy cam. The first term I want to introduce you to is der Spiegel, singular, die Spiegel, plural, mirrors. I personally like to have some nice little Spiegel in the Wohnung. Die Wohnung singular, die Wohnungen plural. Now to a big secret. Wenn man in einen Spiegel blickt, sieht man sein eigenes Spiegelbild. When you look into a mirror, you see your own reflection. Shock. But honestly, one thing you might have not thought about yet, although it's pretty obvious when you think about it, did you know that the Spiegelbild you see in a Spiegel, otherwise it wouldn't be a Spiegelbild, right? It's actually not 100% synchronized with the Gegenwart, die Gegenwart. And obviously there's no plural for that. Duh. Das Auge, singular, die Augen, plural. Can't notice that tiny difference in time. And the exact time difference depends on the distance, for instance. But this difference does exist, and it's there. Even though it might be very tiny. In other, more mysterious and tense words, so to speak, the Spiegelbild is always a tiny little bit in the Vergangenheit. Ooh, die Vergangenheit. If you also have a Katze, you can also show them their own reflection and confuse them a little bit. It's die Katze, singular, die Katzen, plural. Obviously, there are different sizes of mirrors. Das ist ein großer Spiegel. That's a large mirror. Das ist ein kleiner Spiegel. That's a small mirror. Now to the second German word. Das ist ein Fernseher. That's a television. A TV. Saying television instead of TV sounds really merkwürdig. Don't you think? Jetzt ist der Fernseher aus. Now the TV is turned off. Ich könnte ihn aber einschalten, or anschalten, but I could turn it on. It's einschalten, or anschalten, and ausschalten, or abschalten. And hey, if you don't have a Spiegel in your house, you could also use a Fernseher as a Spiegel.
Oh yeah, it's magic.
And it's also das Haus singular, die Häuser plural. Yes, in Umlaut, great. And finally, for today's video, das ist ein Teppich. That's a carpet. It's der Teppich, singular, die Teppiche, plural. They can be made of several different Farben. Die Farbe, singular, die Farben, plural. And when you come home from an awesome party and you're totally betrunken, you can also use it as a bet. It's betrunken. And das Bett Singular, die Betten Plural. I hope you've enjoyed this first episode and also the mixture of German and English. Das Fenster. Plural, die Fenster. And in this case it's das offene Fenster, because it's open. Die Schuhe. Plural, Singular, der Schuh. And they are standing on a Schuhregal. Die Steckdose. Plural, die Steckdosen. Die Heizung, which is the regular term for it, and the more technical term would be der Heizkörper. Der Fernseher, in this case it's an old Röhrenfernseher. Die Fernbedienung, with dust on it. Der Staub. Der Regenschirm, Singular. Plural, die Regenschirme. And this little red thing over there is a Teppich. Der Teppich. Plural, die Teppiche. Der Schrank. And in this case you could call it der Schlafzimmerschrank, because it's standing in the bedroom, im Schlafzimmer. Der Vlog Dave. Die Lampe, or die Nachttischlampe. Der Nachttisch, or das Nachtschränkchen. Das Bett. Plural, die Betten. Die Bettdecke. And the tiger-like stuff you're seeing there is der Bettbezug. Das Bettlaken. Das Kopfkissen. A rather general term would be das Kissen. Plural, die Kissen. And now to something hidden, a secret. Ta-da! Der Lattenrost. And by the way, Lattenrost ist keine Geschlechtskrankheit. If you know what this means, you're a cool dude. Let me say this. It's a pretty silly joke. This big thingy is die Matratze. Quite heavy. Let's start with this thingy. I don't know what you call this one, but we Germans refer to it by saying das Telefon, Singular, die Telefone, Plural, the telephone. Mit einem Telefon kann man telefonieren. You can make phone calls with a telephone. Magic! Who would have thought? Mit einem Telefon kann man jemanden anrufen. You can call someone with a telephone. Interesting, Dave. Tell me more. Usually you need to press certain Tasten with Nummern on them. It's die Taste, Singular. Die Tasten, Plural. The key. And die Nummer, Singular. Die Nummern, Plural, numbers. Ich wähle die Nummer meiner Oma. Or ich wähle die Telefonnummer meiner Oma. I'm entering my grandma's telephone number. You could very well say that, but usually we just say, ich rufe meine Oma an. I'm calling my grandma. Or in this specific case, ich rufe den Teufel an. I'm calling the devil. Now to something more peaceful. These things make every room look more peaceful and better, I think. I'm talking about die Pflanze, singular, die Pflanzen, plural, plants. As it's the case for most terms that begin in PF, the combination of these two consonants in German, Germans rather verbalize it as an F, as a single F sound. Die Pflanze versus die Pflanze. In this case, you could also refer to this one by saying die Blume, singular, die Blumen, plural, flowers. Nicht alle Pflanzen sind Blumen, aber alle Blumen sind Pflanzen. Except for the artificial ones, I guess. Well, that's getting a bit out of control, a bit too philosophical for my taste, don't you think? Die Blume ist im Blumentopf auf der Fensterbank. The flowers in the flower pot on the windowsill. For der Blumentopf, singular, die Blumentöpfe, plural, the flower pot. And die Fensterbank, singular, die Fensterbänke, plural, the windowsills. Pflanzen and Blumen can be found both drinnen or innen, inside, and draußen or außen, outside. It's raining outside right now. Gerade regnet es draußen, but if I wanted to go outside, it would be better to have a key with me. Do you know or remember the German term for key and its articles? If so, tell me in the comments. Generally speaking, this is a Schrankwand. Die Schrankwand, singular. Die Schrankwände, plural. A wall or shelf unit. You can place many different Dinge in it. For instance, Bücher. Das Buch, singular. Die Bücher, plural. Ich lese ein Buch. I'm reading a book. But to be honest, if I had to choose between reading a book and listening to music, there is a chance I might rather listen to a Lied or even a whole album. Das Lied, singular. Die Lieder, plural. The song. Das Album, singular. Die Alben, plural. Albums. These are my dad's CDs. He has put them into a Regal. Das Regal, singular. Die Regale, plural. The shelf. So, what do we have here? Lots of stuff, that's for sure. For example, we have die Mikrowelle. Die Petmaschine. Der Toaster. Die Kaffeemaschine. Der Wasserkocher. Die Fritteuse. Die Spüle. Das Küchenmesser. Plural, die Küchenmesser. Der Schneebesen. Das Messer. Plural, die Messer. Die Gabel. Plural, die Gabeln. Der Löffel. Or der Esslöffel. Or der Suppenlöffel. Plural, die Löffel. And combined, it's das Besteck. Plural, die Bestecke. From left to right. Der Esslöffel, der Teelöffel. Die Gabel, die Kuchengabel. So the little ones are der Teelöffel and die Kuchengabel. Die Schere. Das Schälmesser. Die Suppenkelle or just die Kelle. Das Backblech. Das Backpapier. Die Alufolie or Aluminiumfolie. But nobody says that. Die Frischhaltefolie. Der Kochtopf and the Kochtopfdeckel or just der Deckel. Plural, die Kochtöpfe or die Töpfe. Die Pfanne or die Bratpfanne. Plural, die Pfannen or die Bratpfannen. We tend to pronounce it not too sharp, so we say Pfannen instead of Pfannen. Die Kuchenform or die Backform. Die Küchenwaage. Der Mixer. Yummy, yummy, yummy. Das Brötchen. Plural, die Brötchen. Der Kuchen, or in this case, der Marmorkuchen. Die Tasse, or die Kaffeetasse. Plural, die Tassen. And it says, ich bin nicht gestört, ich bin eine limited edition. It's kinda true. Das Glas, or das Trinkglas. Die Spülmaschine. And inside is das Geschirr. Die Getränke. Singular, das Getränk. Der Backofen or just der Ofen. Der Herd and this is das Ceranfeld. Der Kühlschrank. Too much stuff for you to show. As you can see, some lights already illuminate die Wohnung singular, die Wohnungen plural, the flat. But here in the Flur, der Flur singular, die Flure plural. It could as well be a bit brighter, don't you think? So Dave, what you gonna do? Well, ich schalte das Licht an. Ich schalte das Licht ein. I'm turning the light on. For das Licht singular, die Lichter plural. You could also choose to refer to another component when you want to express this. Ich schalte die Lampe an. Ich schalte die Lampe ein. I'm turning the lamp on. This object as a whole is called die Lampe, singular, die Lampen, plural, a lamp. Schalte an and schalte ein refer to two different verbs which at the end of the day actually mean the same. Einschalten, anschalten, to turn or switch something on. Instead of using the verbs einschalten or anschalten, I could also use a conjugated form of anmachen, which in a literal sense means to make something on. Ich mache das Licht an. You can very well say anmachen instead of anschalten, but you can't say einmachen in this context. I mean, we have the verb einmachen in the German language, but it actually means to confect, to preserve something, for instance, some kind of food. By the way, jemanden anmachen means, well, to make a move on someone. There's also the phrase das macht mich an, that turns me on. Of course, a lamp can't shine on its own. It requires a Leuchtmittel, an illuminant, to produce light. I'm talking about something like this, a Glühbirne, a light bulb. Die Glühbirne is one of those interesting German compound words, because translated literally it means glow pear. Yeah, I mean it's not too far off considering its shape, I don't think. There are different sizes and also types of lamps. This one is called a Leuchtstoffröhre. Die Leuchtstoffröhre, singular, die Leuchtstoffröhren, plural, a neon tube. Der Leuchtstoff means luminescent or fluorescent substance. And it's die Röhre, singular, die Röhren, plural. Germans call this type of lamp der Deckenfluter, singular, die Deckenfluter, plural. A ceiling flutter, so to speak, meaning a lamp that floods the ceiling with light. The proper English term is floor uplighter or simply uplight. And yeah, in comparison, this lamp is rather groß, big. By the way, as a little reprise, so to speak, do you know or even remember from last episode what this is called in German? If so, tell me in the comments. This lamp is rather klein, small. You might be able to turn on the lights by clapping or tipping on the lamp, if you have a really fancy lamp, that is, but normally we'd use a Lichtschalter. Der Lichtschalter, singular. Die Lichtschalter, plural. Light switch. Ich betätige den Lichtschalter. I'm using or activating the light switch. Ich drücke den Lichtschalter. I'm pressing the light switch. Very often, German light switches come along with a Steckdose. Die Steckdose, singular. Die Steckdosen, plural. A plug socket or an electrical outlet. This is Pepper, our female Katze. It's die Katze, singular. Die Katzen, plural. Which either means cats in general, as a hypernym, so to speak, or it refers especially to a female cat. A tomcat, meaning a male cat, like Hugo, her brother, is called der Kater, singular, die Kater, plural. Again, if you want to refer to him without using or knowing his gender, you can simply say die Katze, as a hypernym. Back to Pepper, she really loves to drink running water, for instance from the bathtub's faucet. And that's also the reason why she really wants me to let her into the bathroom right now. Actually, talking about the bathroom, if you want to learn German words for typical things in various rooms, click my German room tour playlist at the end of this video. Ich mache das Licht aus. Ich schalte das Licht aus. Anyway, there is something in her way though. Die Tür, singular. Die Türen, plural. The door. Ich öffne die Tür. I'm opening the door. Ich mache die Tür auf. For aufmachen, meaning to make something open. Let's learn more door-related vocabulary in the upcoming episode of Learn German Words for Things Around the House. Also make sure to hit the like button and to spread the word about this channel, since that really, really helps a lot. Die Toilette. Or das Klo. Der Klodeckel.
Die Klobrille. Der Spülkasten. Die Klobürste. Das Klopapier. Der Handtuchhalter. Das Handtuch. Die Nagelfeile. Der Rasierer. Die Nagelschere. Die Haarbürste. Die Zahnpasta und die Zahnbürste. Die Pinzette. And for the lovely Sam Walton man, der Waschlappen.
Waschlappen.
Die Armatur. Der Wasserhahn. Die Badewanne. Der Stöpsel. Die Badematte. Mit Saugnäpfen. Die Dusche. And what is coming out of the Duschkopf? Der Duschkopf. Or der Brausekopf. Die Duschkabine. Der Duschschwamm. Das Duschgel. Das Shampoo oder das Haarshampoo. Das Haarspray. As we Germans like to say it, das Haarspray. Das Deo. By the way, it's a very cool Deo. I like it. Der frisch geduschte Vlog Dave.
Actually, let's begin with a little reprise. A nod to the previous episode, so to speak. Even though this video deals with this thingy, well, I won't reveal what it's called in German, because I've already done that in the previous episode. But maybe you actually remember or know what this is called in German. If so, tell me in the comments. I'm so mean, I know. Sometimes you have to pick things up where you've left them, and in this case, we're gonna continue standing in front of the bathroom door. As we've learned, my Katze Pepper likes to drink running water from the bathtub faucet, and of course I'm opening the door for her. Because I'm not that mean after all. A proper door needs to be framed, of course. It's surrounded by a Türrahmen or Türzarge. The more common term is der Türrahmen though. It's Der Türrahmen, Singular. Die Türrahmen, Plural. Dieser Türrahmen besteht aus Holz. This door frame is made of wood. A proper German door also requires a Türklinke, because otherwise you can't really interact with it. At least not overly accurate or properly. People will also get what you mean though, when you just refer to it by saying die Klinke, Singular, die Klinken, Plural. Ich betätige die Türklinke. I'm using the door handle. Some doors rather feature a Türknauf though. Der Türknauf, Singular. Die Türknäufe, Plural. Ich drehe den Türknauf. I'm turning the doorknob. I'm not too sure about this, but if I remember correctly, doorknobs are more common in the US compared to Germany, I guess? Or was it actually the other way around? I don't really know. Maybe you guys know more about that and can tell me. In my experience, it's mostly these kinds of doors that have a Türknauf instead of a Klinke, because this door leads into and out of the flat. There are actually various different names or words for this door. Usually it's either die Wohnungstür, the apartment door, or die Etagentür, the floor door, so to speak, an entrance door on each floor. Die Eingangstür, the entrance door, which is a comparatively more general term that could also be used for this kind of door. Die Haustür, the house door, which is the actual proper door that leads into the house. When you think about it, it's actually an outdoor door, so to speak. An indoor door, meaning a door within a flat to a room, is also called die Zimmertür, the room door, which is a general term. You could also refer to these doors by including and mentioning the respective room they lead into. For instance, die Küchentür, die Badezimmertür, die Wohnzimmertür, die Esszimmertür, die Schlafzimmertür, and so on. Usually a Türklinke as a whole is also closely accompanied by this, a Schloss. No, not this kind of a Schloss though. Yep, the German neuter noun das Schloss actually is a so-called Teekesselchen, a little tea kettle so to speak. In the German language, das Teekesselchen is a colloquial term that refers to a word that has at least two different meanings. Das Schloss, Singular, die Schlösser, Plural, can either mean palace or it means lock. Another more precise term is das Türschloss, Singular, die Türschlösser, Plural, the door lock. This hole is called das Schlüsselloch, Singular, die Schlüssellöcher, Plural, the keyhole. Ich schaue durch das Schlüsselloch. I'm looking through the keyhole. And of course, a keyhole requires a key. Der Schlüssel, Singular. Die Schlüssel, Plural. The key. Ich stecke den Schlüssel in das Schlüsselloch. I'm putting the key into the keyhole. Ich schließe die Tür auf. I unlock the door. Ich schließe die Tür ab. I lock the door. It's really inconvenient to have various keys loosely in your pocket. So one day someone actually invented a Schlüsselbund. It's der Schlüsselbund, Singular, and either die Schlüsselbunde, Plural, or die Schlüsselbünde, Plural. And sometimes a Schlüsselbund is attached to a Schlüsselband. Das Schlüsselband, Singular, die Schlüsselbänder, Plural. The literal translation of Schlüsselband is key ribbon or key belt. And this is also a great example of how a meaning can change if just one letter changes. Der Schlüsselbund. Das Schlüsselband. I hope you've learned something new and found this video helpful and interesting.
Okay, so here we go. Der Sprudelkasten. Die Sprudelflasche. You could call all this das Gerümpel. Stuff flying around, randomly, so to speak. Oh, what do we have here? Die Leiter. Some Stühle. Der Gefrierschrank. Yummy, yummy. Good German beer. Feltins. Don't forget to shut the light off. Close the door.
Die Waschküche.
What is this? This is a Waschmaschine. Die Waschmaschine. Ein Korb. Waschpulver. Die Wäsche. Ah! Der Besen. Der Eimer.
Der Handfeger.
Das Putzzeug. Der Wasserschlauch oder auch der Gartenschlauch. You can also have a Trockner or der Wäschetrockner. Der Stromzähler. Plural die Stromzähler. Do you know those? Die Wäscheklammer. Der gelbe Sack. Die Wäscheleine. Don't forget to shut the light. There it is. So this was open. Let's leave it as that. Vorsicht, Stufe. Der Wasserboiler oder auch der Boiler. Das Rohr, Singular. Die Rohre, Plural. And I think that's it. And yeah. That's our cellar, basically. Do you rather say basement or do you rather say cellar? Der Keller.
Ooh.
I'm Dave. You don't need to translate that.
Die Auflage. Der Blumentopf. Die Steine. Der Busch. Die Blumen. Plural. Singular. Die Blume. Der Rasen. Oder auch die Wiese. Das Marienröschen. Plural. Die Marienröschen. Der Löwenzahn, which literally means the lion's tooth. Die Gießkanne, Singular, Plural, die Gießkannen. Der Gartenschlauch. Der Wasserspeicher. Das Regenrohr. Der Komposter. Der Kompost. Die Büsche, Plural. Oh, look, another Komposter. Die Tulpen, Plural. Singular, die Tulpe. Der Buchsbaum. Der Gartenzaun. Or der Zaun. Die Bank. Or die Sitzbank. Die Gartenliege, or die Liege. Hypernym, die Gartenmöbel. Die Sonnenschirmhalterung.
Some little weird garden toy. That's blowing in the wind. When it's windy outside. Like this. Isn't it beautiful?
Yes, it is.
Die Ranke. Die Gartenhütte. Or die Gartenlaube. Der Rasenmäher. Die Wäschespinne. Der Fahrradhelm. Oder der Radhelm. Die Gartenhandschuhe. Das Fahrrad.
But we normally say das Fahrrad.
Oh, look! Gartenzwerge. Plural, Singular, der Gartenzwerg. Die
Harke. Das Moos. Oh, another Regenrohr. Connected to die Regenrinne. Die Garage. Der Lichtschalter. Das Garagentor. Die Harke. Die Schaufel. Die Leiter. Der Laubbläser. Der Dünger. Or das Düngemittel. Der Vertikultierer. Der Handfeger. Das Kehrblech. Der Spachtel. Der Besen. Mit roten Borsten. Der Rechen. Oder der Laubbesen. Das Thermometer. And that's it.